technology has revolutionized every aspect of human life. We know that humans inhabit just 30% of our Earth, and a vast majority of this area is already using technology to better itself, to improve the lives of humans and their ecosystem. From enhancing communication to setting up satellites till disposing garbage, technology's effects are already evident. But what about the other 70% of our Earth? Our oceans that sustain us, our oceans that play a vital role in shaping the livelihood of people residing across the globe, our oceans that influence the Earth's temperature, determine the oxygen level, and provide a home for countless animals and plants. Do we give them their due consideration? Are oceans cleaner and safer anymore? Well, you know the answer, and we must be shameful for our answer. My visit to beaches these days are not as memorable as they used to be. Being an ocean lover, I am pained to read about its degeneration. Oceans and marine ecosystems are becoming vulnerable due to human activities. Or I should say, inhuman activities. Currently, single-use plastics constitute the majority of ocean plastic pollution, posing a significant threat to marine beings. Now imagine yourself as a whale swimming across the vast Caribbean Sea. Your whole family is going to migrate to North Atlantic. But you're unable to swim. You're unable to breathe. Plastics have completely blocked your throat. There is no way for oxygen to enter your lungs. It's impossible for you to reach the surface and help yourself live a happy life once again. Sadly, this is the real condition of a marine ecosystem. But what if I tell you that technology, which is used to improve our lives, could also be used more effectively to improve the lives of aquatic animals? Yes, it's our responsibility to protect and preserve marine ecosystem with a better use of technology. As the first step, it is important to understand animals' behavior and habitat. For this, animal telemetry is used. Animal telemetry, which involves marine animals to carry electronic tags, significantly improves our understanding of animals. Moreover, they are also used to monitor ocean. The data collected from these tags further show how animals respond to climate change and human disturbances. In 2005, during an unusual influx of warm water along the west coast of America, telemetry data showed that sea lions traveled further than normal from the shore. The data helped scientists not only to understand the unusual migration pattern due to ocean temperature rises, but also reveal their preferred prey. Ocean is a key factor in the storage and transfer of heat energy across the globe. The movement of this heat energy through local and global ocean currents affects the regulation of local weather conditions. So there are technologically driven mechanisms which are used to study ocean currents. They are drifters. They have different sensors and special instruments to measure temperature, pressure, salinity and wind speed. The 1,167 drifters across the globe lets us understand the distribution of heat, oxygen and nutrients. Dorg, also known as sea anchor, is designed to move along the near surface ocean currents, finding their velocity. For understanding ocean, it's also important to track and preserve marine endangered species. In the deep areas of sea where GPS signals are unavailable, a few special cameras are used to track different animals. Specifically, special infrared cameras are used to track whale migration. The cameras mounted on ships or on shores track whale in the daytime as well as in the nights. Grey whales, which were considered vulnerable before 1994, now see a steady growth in their population with the use of this technology. The areas where whales are spotted during migration are alerted, and ships traveling in those regions slow down to support whale migration. This way, IoT-based technologies play a vital role in marine conservation. But not all countries in the world use IoT-based technology for marine conservation. India, being a hotspot of biodiversity, is home to a wide variety of marine beings. Having a long coastline of over 7,500 kilometers, India has to conserve its unique marine species. So India has taken a few initiatives to do that. Dugong is a unique marine mammal residing in Park Bay besides the state of Tamil Nadu. But it has seen a decrease in its population due to habitat loss. Currently, there are just 240 dugongs in India, majority found in Tamil Nadu. So in 2021, the government of Tamil Nadu announced Dugong Conservation Reserve in Park Bay with an area of 448 square kilometers. This was established to protect the marine endangered species and its habitat. Olive redly turtle is one of the marine species which nests along the coast of Tamil Nadu. Nearly 10 to 20 nests are spotted every kilometer on the coast. This turtle is often caught accidentally by fishermen while fishing. And to prevent the bycatch of this turtle, a device called TED, that is Turtle Excluding Device, is used. When a large turtle enters the net, the spring hatches and deploys a grid, allowing the turtle to move out. There are mechanisms for marine conservation. Policies and measures are already intact. But are we doing enough? That's the question we need to raise. So the government should set up more research and development centers. Fishermen, researchers, and industries should work together collaboratively for new IoT-based inventions. Yes, I meant fishermen also. The general perception is that fishermen are an ignorant lot, leading a vulnerable life. But fishermen knowing much about ocean and marine animals would give significant information to researchers, which would result in better solution. The collaborative effort of diverse people will mitigate ocean depletion, benefit fishermen, foster industrial growth, and drive India's development through technological advancements. It's our duty to conserve our oceans. It's we who have the responsibility to replenish the ruining beauty of our oceans. So let's be more mindful of our conservation of marine beings, and let's mindfully enhance our technological skills with the understanding that our oceans too need our help. And I hope that my visit to beaches will become more memorable again. Thank you.